But it makes me believe when people say about how the level of play in North America has been shooting up. I'm like, I mean, you see it, right? When there's stuff like that. So now we have KD3 up against etab, our last winner's quarter set here, and KD3 starting it off with the Jigglypuff. Kind of surprising. They might have, well, I don't know, they wouldn't have blind picked, right? Because he just knows that etab is
I mean,
going
etab deep. Only plays Pika. So.
Yeah, but going for the Puff into Pikachu when he has such a strong Falcon, right? He beat Wario with his Falcon, and he's picking Puff's like hardest matchup for game one here.
Oh yeah, just a brutal matchup as Puff. But you know, the thing about KD3 is he just loves Puff.
Yeah, that's
yeah,
true.
Yeah, he's with me on that point. Puff's so fun to play, and sometimes
if
you just
he can
feel
do
like
it with Puff, then he'll do it with Puff.
You know, he probably can. Yeah, KD3, probably the strongest Puff in North America, honestly.
Yeah, I mean, you don't always see him using it, right? Like, he's not a dedicated solo main like some of, you know, our other top Puffs, like CTG, for example. But when he pulls it out, he knows how to use it.
Oh, for sure.
Maybe something you see, like, more often from him against, like, Falcons.
Yeah,
like
he
that.
Tends to destroy the Falcon players with Puff. He also tends to pull out the Puff against Yoshi. I've seen him really work some Yoshis. In
oh,
matchup.
Yeah.
Matchup I don't even like. I'm kind of unpleasant as Puff, but 83 is just so good at it.
Up air rest.
Here we can see, speaking of this lead here against etab and Puff's arguably worse
You find
matchup.
that stray hit into grab against Pika, like, or through up air rest, unless the player you're fighting has insane DI, always gonna work. And even at zero, if Puff grabs Pika at zero, like under side plat, you can do forward throw up air rest. And it'll just
I love this back and forth here. Etab with some great punishes off 83's ledge options.
Yeah, and he caught him. 83
with some
very
great
few
recoveries
jumps.
Here.
Forward tilt, hey, yeah, a very refined looking edge guard from Etab.
Looking experienced in the matchup, and he evens it up at 2 stocks to 2 against a formidable player in KD3, so. It's another one of these up-and-coming Rochester players, man.
It's all the Rochester scene, like 6 of them entered tonight, which is so cool because it just pushes up the attendance for the tournament. Shout out to everyone.
I'm so proud of them, man.
And like,
I'm so proud of those guys.
Yeah, what a night for them too. I mean, Lord Ted's performance and like Baba Kanoush taking a game off of Dogs. Like, what? They have all been like playing with each other and grinding so much lately. It's awesome to see the result of that, and we'll see if etab is able to prove his own against such a strong player in KD3 here.
And nice juicy combo there, but KD3 with plenty of jumps to make it back. No.
Up tilt.
A little too high percent. He's up the out of this, or he's doomed. Finds the escape and turns the situation around. Yeah, nice work from etab.
Oh, and that
falling up there. Wow, and calls out his recovery.
Massive.
These guys just firing back and forth, both playing really well, I feel like.
That could be so big. If etab is able to take game one here, he will be poising himself for a very, very surprising set win.
It can be difficult for Puff to find kills at this percent.
Can 83 hold on? He needs to find like up tilt or something, right? But etab is just building up the damage, and we've seen him execute some really good edge guards.
No, he goes too low! He's the DI out of this. Man,
out of that
escape, but wow, what a scary situation. KD3 now trying to pressure him.
Back air.
No, the
up tilt back air.
Finds the up tilt.
That's it.
That doesn't quite
it.
Kill.
Oh my gosh.
And KD3 recover here.
He's got a lot of resources right now. That's a really tough position to seal the turn. If you get up tilt back air and it doesn't kill, the Puff is so high up by then, right? So she has a lot of ways to descend back to the stage and make it really tough. Spotting him out of the air with that up air. KD3 low on
jumps
right now.
From KD3. Kind of an awkward position. I wonder if he could have just turned around and grabbed. No, DI's the wrong way, and the downer is going to do
it.
Wow, what a close game one.
Yeah, taking him to 101% on the last stock. And I wonder if KD3 is going to stick with the Puff after that one.
But you can't really feel like that's a game that feels too secure. I mean, sure you won, but. Jeez, almost any interaction. It felt like that was barely too far to grab him at that one and a point.
Yeah.
The downer hadn't worked. I mean, even the up tilt bear could have killed very easily.
He could just be pretty sure that, you know, if he does lose a next game with Puff, then things will be alright. He can just counterpick to one of his stronger matchups, like a Pika Ditto or a Falcon Pika. I say counterpick because, you know, like if he goes down a game, etab is just a Pika main. He probably has some confidence that he'd be able to take him out if the Puff doesn't work. So I do, I expect if KD3 were to drop this game, he'd probably switch. But, you know, maybe we'll have to see what happens. Maybe he'll just take it 2-0.
Oh, that jump!
Especially
the pound turning him around, but Colby stalks him.
Oh, man.
This is a top 8 qualifier, by the way. Can't believe that
he's like, online tournament? I'll be stuck. Huge double back air.
83 is the, hit the homie. Back air, a little stale, so it's probably not gonna kill. 83 kind of baiting here. He has tons of jumps, but sort of acting like he doesn't. Dang it. Tab is gonna do anything drastic, but of course he doesn't.
He went for the down B so late there. Not maybe quite recognizing that it was his only option. Maybe if he went for it a little earlier, he could have set up for a double. But that's like some pretty advanced Pikachu stuff.
Yeah, it's, I'm kind of impressed that he even hit. Certainly KD3 didn't expect it. Wow! That DI and up B looked so good, but somehow KD3 hit him anyway. That's the stock trade. Jeez. Yeah, I would taunt after that too. That feels rough as Pikachu.
Crazy plays.
Well, nice combo here.
He's finding himself in a dangerous spot again, just pushing himself off the stage and forcing that up B out. He gave KD3 the grab, but it didn't really lead to anything. That's again, we see Puff very high up in the air. Too many options.
Oh, just gets
really
the bear turnaround jab grab. That should do it. I was just saying etab seems like he's struggling to kill, but I guess not. Just pull out these jab grabs.
Yeah, just one more stock here for him.
Etab looking to force a game 3.
If you find the right hit here with like a descending aerial, you can just set up a kill combo as Pika on Puff. You know, those horizontal combos are no joke.
Add these low percents for both sides can honestly be some of the most dangerous. Both of them have access to these big combos. 83, of course. Those are the rest combos against Pikachu at these low percents.
Etab waited for a tech roll in there, I think. And KD3 did not give it to him after that knockdown on the platform.
Well, that call out of the bear! Safe bear landing!
He's got very little resources left here.
Oh, needed to F-tilt, I think.
Great reaction tech, Jace. Going for the weak aerial into rest again. I think maybe F-throw rest would have just worked there.
Great recovery there from KD3, but still, you really don't want to be building up percent like this. Gonna hit you because Pikachu has another stock to play with, and of course, Puff needs to get both of them done here.
He
needs to find the stock and then maybe convert into a
rest. That could be it. Doesn't turn around
from
the F-tilt.
You can tell etab tends to be better at the DI to the left, and so when he gets put in these situations where DI to the left is the right move, it's really difficult to.
Oh, if he didn't miss
the dash, I think, yeah.
Yeah. He put his shield up when he Z-canceled. And if that didn't happen, that was like a run of up smash, right? Or like
he was a little high to get the up smash, but he definitely gets something. Ooh, nice shield there from KD3 baiting the push off. Being able to get that corner pressure. Ooh, I really like that recovery from etab. It's kind of subtle, but he pulls back.
Oh my gosh.
Where you have bees.
This stock right now has been going on for so long.
Yeah, both these guys know how pivotal this is, and I think going so long is really favoring etab. I mean, look at how much damage he's been able to build up.
Yeah,
he still has another stock he can bring out.
Essentially, yeah. That stock deficit is just making this war of attrition such a disadvantage for KD3. Even if he finds
it's already rough in the matchup. Pika has just so many strong kill options.
A back air away from death at all times. Using the pounds away, reminding me of like Y-bomb recoveries.
I think etab forgot that he still had all his jumps and goes for that up air commitment. 83 is just so tricky.
Oh,
but he just calls him out.
Can't trick him on that one. etab getting up there with the back air, calling out the position. And KD3 The ball is in his court now. What counter pick shall I go with today? What does he feel comfortable with? What is going to secure this set? Pikachu Ditto makes a lot of sense. I feel like I had this conversation with you recently where it's like, if you feel like you're the stronger player, just Pika Ditto. You know?
Oh, yeah. You want to get that variance low. You know, it's game three, top eight qualifier. You don't want to mess around and gamble on a Falcon Ditto. We've seen Etab's edge guards in that matchup are very strong. And even if you feel like you're the better player, how confident are you that you can deny him four grabs, right? Pikachu Ditto, you're going to have a lot more chances to prove yourself and really minimize that chance of like a coin flip variance outcome.
Yeah, and like we've seen that like against like his, you know, highest level peers, KD3 does tend to go with the Falcon. It's what he used against like Josh and Wario and low power. But, you know, here in this matchup, Etab's still a newer player, probably not quite up on the same level.
Hey, he's the Pikachu against me, so
he's feels like more threatened maybe by the Pikachu, or like he feels like he's more of a more threatened by the Pika Falcon is what I meant to say. The KD3 would just, yeah, like you said, be worried about getting hit by those grabs. Here in the Pika Ditto, you gotta work so hard, and if you have that neutral edge over the opponent, it's just gonna be so difficult. Oh, that could have been an up smash.
It's so difficult to win neutral interaction after neutral interaction that you need to do to win this matchup.
Really committal down air from KD3 there.
Makes it work. Yeah. Hard read, I think, on that up B to the top platform.
He doesn't. He's doing a lot of these full drift in down airs. I mean, it's committal if you're positioned right to counter it, but if you're a little too close, it covers so much space. You see Etab taking a page out of his playbook there with the same thing.
And KD3 messes up his up B, but still just gets F smashed in the face anyway.
I love that. He like stopped in midair in slow motion. He's like, uh-oh. And then the forward smash.
Uh-oh, yeah.
Oh,
speaking of uh-oh.
Oh, like the Nair is in the wrong way.
Nice up B to escape the pressure.
That's a regrab.
Grab chain, yeah.
Oh, he up B'd out.
Yeah, it's still a lot of percent.
You can
go for the ledge attack.
Yeah, you can go for ledge there. That's what I was about to say. That's what a lot of like the highest level Pikachus tend to do out of that grab chain is go for the ledge. I remember actually I was playing like Pika Dittos with John one of the times that he returned to the States, and he kept doing that to me, and eventually I started just running past and dash attacking the ledge, which was a way to counter that up the ledge attempt. But yeah, obviously, you know, don't get a lot off of a dash attack at that percent. Still worth going for. KD3 just looking so good right now in this Ditto. Huge comfortable lead for him. It's gonna be so tough for Etab, but that's a good start.
Yeah, finds the grab. That's what I was thinking. Is like, you know, when you have that lead, but you're at a ton of percent, you need to find a bit of the extra credit, and KD3 wasn't able to this time, so game will stay competitive, but certainly not the position you're hoping to be in if you're the newer player trying to make an upset. But no jump here from KD3. This is a lot of damage, but great ledge cancel.
He's waiting for those up tilts.
Oh, misses in the tech chase. I think that's happened
a few
times.
I thought that was gonna work. Goes for the up B call out, and he had the right idea. Just very
again,
slightly
the tech
mispositioned.
Chase.
Oh, that up tilt. So
yeah,
late.
Nice awareness, but Etab just gets the grab, and suddenly we're in a last stock situation.
Pivot grabs, that's old reliable, right?
Yeah, for sure.
Can't go wrong with that.
And this lead that KD3 had is kind of starting to evaporate. Gotta start feeling a little nervous, even at 85%, you know. He calls out that downer.
He's gotta find like something like that, an anti-air on the downer. But KD3's not gonna give him the opportunity to make it back to the stage.
Yeah, just a perfect edge guard there from KD3.
So a 2-1 win over Etab for KD3 is going to make KD3 move on to the top 8. And I think maybe we